Let's do some ESD test measurements. These are necessary before we are allowed to sell an electronic product. Therefore, let's take an old oscilloscope with that crazy screen as our first device under test. This scope is placed on a metallic plate, which is connected to ground with about 1 mega ohm. Our ESD gun must be connected to ground as well. For this, we simply attach its reference to our measuring cell to ensure a low impedance connection. Let's start with air discharges. Here we need a round tip, which is simulating a fingertip. Let's choose 8 kilovolts as our test voltage. Here you can see a discharge at such voltage level. Now we hold that voltage at the tip and move the gun quickly closer to the DOT until we hit its surface. Since the display is not metallic, there is no strike yet. Instead, you can hear a slight sizzle. Now, I test the number field. Again, no discharge. But sometimes, discharge occurs when there is some metal casing right behind that plastic case. When that happens, I have to reload the gun. Anyway, the device is still working without any problems. In a real compliance test measurement, we would have to work way more accurate. We would also have to test with negative polarity, for example. But in our video, we will proceed with contact discharges now. Therefore, we now switch to the pointy tip and reduce the test voltage to 4 kV. We will now start with an indirect ESD test. For this, we unload our gun horizontally to the metal plate. The device continues to function properly. Now we come to direct ESD discharges. To do this, we first place our tip on the surface and only then perform the discharge. Still no problems. But we haven't tested the backside yet. Let's try a few tests here as well. This knob looks suspicious because it goes directly into the casing. Ooh, the device is rebooting. Such a thing must not happen according to today's standards. So you would not be allowed to sell this product today. Let me demonstrate this situation again in a more realistic scenario. Underneath me, there is a plastic floor. Thus it is safe to shoot myself with the gun. Now I am charged with 4 kV and approach my hand to the scope's back until it comes to an air discharge. 4 kV is a very typical value after walking on a plastic carpet, and it's enough to cause the scope to reboot. By the way, the only reason I use the key is to make it more convenient for me. I will do now some experiments with my private iPhone XS. I've bought it in the year 2019. Now we have the end of 2021. And my supervisor suggested me not to do those experiments now, but I will now try to do some ESD discharges on the iPhone XS. I fully trust Apple here that they carefully test their products at high voltages. At least I hope so. And I can well imagine that Apple is using a test robot for this because you have to go through a wide variety of test scenarios. Once the phone is plugged into a charger, once it's not. Once I use the camera app, then I might make a phone call. So Apple must test through a lot of scenarios. I will just open the camera app and see if it continues to work after an ESD discharge. Test number 1, indirect ESD discharge. An iPhone survives. Test number 2, direct ESD discharges. I will do these on some metallic surfaces. Let's try the speaker. iPhone still is alive. But I have to discharge the phone again after each test. To do this, I simply plug in the lightning cable and connect its ground to our metal plate. Now let's try the lightning port itself. Ooh, there was a spark. But it still works. Don't forget to discharge the phone again. Test number 3, air discharges. Let's therefore switch back to the round tip and increase the voltage to 8 kV. Here you can see again the discharge on the metal plate. I just don't want to scratch my phone, that's why I'm a little more careful here. Looks like my iPhone is still alive. Turn over once. This should also discharge the display again. Then once again a test on the back, including the camera. It looks to me like everything is still working. Well done, Apple.